Over the last 4 years, I've had the unusual privilege of visiting with a group of farmers who do things well differently. They typically don't till. They use cover crops as an integral part of their management strategy and not as an afterthought. And they embrace diversity. Call them crazy if you like, but these guys report more consistent yields, lower input costs, and higher net income. They call this soil health. Now, with my mineral processing background, I first viewed the soil as an inert medium to grow plants, sort of like a factory. From where I stood, these farms looked like anomalies. I mean, how do you get more from less, right? But these guys weren't sneaking out to fertilize and irrigate at night. And since science respects empiricism, I had to believe what I saw. With each visit, these anomalies amassed. Was my science wrong? No, but it was incomplete. Maybe it was my understanding of soils that I needed to question. Chris Nichols pointed out to me that 90% of soil function is actually mediated by microbes. Wow! I went to the literature and I saw that it was true. And as the pieces of this puzzle began to fall into place, I realized that I no longer viewed soils as inert media, but as living, mutualistic ecosystems. According to physicist and philosopher Thomas Kuhn, I had just undergone a paradigm shift. So if biology is so important, why has our understanding of its imprint on our soils over the last 60 years been largely descriptive? Maybe it's because measuring these effects is hard. Now, if it's harder to measure, is the science less valid? I think not. The question is, can science explain the success that we see on these fields, or will they remain anomalies? In this series, I invite you to take a road trip with me to visit with scientists who share this paradigm of soils. Our conversations range from rhizobacteria to landscape-scale nutrient recycle, and most everything in between. So, you gonna join me? If you are, you better buckle up. It's going to be a wild ride.